Hey everyone, welcome back. So today I thought that I would do a little bit of a different video for you guys. I'm going to be doing best of the boxes. So this is my monthly roundup where I kind of go through my favorite items for the month of June. These are the items that I am grabbing every day while I'm getting ready or just like to touch up, throwing in my bag. So if you are interested in seeing what my favorites were from this month's subscription boxes, then just stay tuned. But before we get into that, please like this video, give it a big thumbs up. That way I know you guys are interested in my monthly roundup of my subscription boxes, as well as subscribe while you're at it. It's completely free and I would love to have you here for future videos. All right, so I'm gonna go ahead and start with like skincare items, I guess, just to kind of get those out of the way. So we did receive this Kylie Skin. This is the foaming face wash in our BoxyCharm. I believe this was the base box. And believe it or not, I've really enjoyed it. You can see I've used, you know, about that much, but it's just like a very luxurious foaming face wash. It doesn't leave my skin feeling stripped or tight or, you know, like dry. And I haven't noticed any breakouts or irritations. I have very sensitive skin. So if something is going to irritate me or cause a breakout, I pretty much know within the first time that I've used it. So yeah, I wouldn't say that this is gonna be your one and done end all face cleanser. I still would recommend doing like a pre-cleanse, removing any makeup, waterproof, long wear products like that, and then going in with this foaming face wash to kind of do like a second cleanse. But yeah, I've really enjoyed this, believe it or not. So this is a big thumbs up for me. All right, next I have the Glow Recipe. This is the Avocado Melt Retinol Sleeping Mask. And again, we got this in our BoxyCharm Premium. I really, really have enjoyed this as well. This is just a very thick, creamy, emollient sleeping mask. You can see I've kind of dug into that quite a bit. And it's like a thick layer that you just put on, you go to sleep in it. And then I definitely notice when I wake up in the morning that my skin just feels really smooth, plump, hydrated. As far as the benefits of the retinol, I couldn't tell you so far because I've only been using it for a couple of weeks, if not maybe a week and a half now. So as the weeks progress, I will keep you guys updated to let you know if this does anything as far as like reversing any age damage or help prevent fine lines and texture from kind of popping out. So I'll let you guys know. And the last sort of like skincare kind of item is this, and this is the Pores No More Luminizer Primer from Dr. Brandt. And I actually got this in my Ipsy Glam Bag Plus. I was kind of, I don't know, I was hesitant on this product just because like I haven't heard the best reviews from the Pores No More kind of line. But this one actually works really, really well. I do notice a huge difference when I wear this, especially in this area right here where, you know, we mostly get our enlarged pores. I have noticed a very smoothing effect as well as my smile lines. So I've noticed a big difference, and especially since I have dry skin, I do like the fact that it has a luminous finish. So even if I use a more full coverage matte foundation with that, because even though I have oily, dry skin, I still like a matte finish sometimes, this will kind of radiate through that. Okay, moving on to the fun stuff, the makeup. So getting back into my Ipsy Glam Bag Plus, I did receive this Gigi Gorgeous, and this is the only blush duo in Authentic and Pride. I wasn't like the most excited to get this blush, I remember, because I thought that it was kind of like repeats, old, thrown in there, just kind of, you know, because this was from the November collaboration with Gigi Gorgeous. But I actually have been using it quite a bit. It's what I have on right now. I kind of like mix between the two. Usually I'll go in with the matte side a little bit more and then just like kind of lightly brush a little bit of the luminous side over it just to kind of give a glowy finish. But I really like this. It's very pigmented. It lasts all day. I don't notice it fading off or anything like that. So yeah, this has been a really big hit with me. So I'm happy now that it was in the bag. At first I was kind of like, this is old, repeats, why you do me like that, Ipsy? But overall, I've actually really, really liked it, and I've grabbed it pretty much every day. The next thing is this, and this is the lip combo that I have on right now. So this is the Pout on Point by Pop Beauty Lip Pencil in Risqué Rose. And then this is the Cab Charming Lip Gloss. So this was Ipsy Glam Bag, and then this was like a BoxyCharm. I've really enjoyed pairing these together. So I'll just do a swatch for you. So that's the pencil right there. So that's the shade. And then the gloss just goes really, really well with it. I think it's like a really nice like contrast. This did come with a liner, but the liner to me is just almost identical to the lip gloss color. I like a little bit more depth and definition and dimension between my gloss or my lipstick and my liner. So I've been pairing these two together because I can kind of get a little bit more of that definition with it. Whereas with the liner that came with this, I feel like it's just too close to the color of the gloss itself. In fact, it's identical. So I've just preferred using that, the Pop Beauty Pout on Point One. So yeah, I've really enjoyed using both of those products together, and that's what I have on right now. And then moving on to the mascara, and this is the Lily Lashes mascara that we got in BoxyCharm. And I really wasn't going to use this. I didn't want to open it. I didn't want to start another mascara because I do have quite a few that I'm going through. But I've just heard such great reviews, and the brush just really intrigued me. I love these like fat, fluffy brushes. This mascara is really, really good. I have it on my lower lashes right now, and it doesn't transfer, bleed, flake, crumble. I have very sensitive eyes. This doesn't burn my eyes. I was actually really impressed with this mascara. I've been like getting some good mascaras in subscription boxes lately, so this did not disappoint. It's very volumizing. It's very lengthening. It's a fast mascara, so you don't have to like sit there and keep building. You will get, I'd say within 2 or 3 swipes, you'll get a really decent payoff of volume, length, and it's very rich and dark and pigmented. So it coats the lashes really, really good. So I love the Triple X mascara from Lily Lashes. Okay, and the last two things that I'm going to talk about are the palettes that I received in my recent boxes. So let's go ahead and start with the Alondra Desi, which is what I have on my eyes today. This is a gorgeous palette. We got this in the box from Fashionsta. So I have on Cotton Candy in the crease, blended out with Sunshine just to kind of give that like yellow halo effect. I did deepen out the crease and lower lash line with Selena, and then I went in with Rosé All Day all over the lid. This is a really beautiful palette, really well done, very thoughtfully curated. All of the colors work really well together. There's a lot of different combinations that you can do, even though it looks very monochromatic as far as like these sunset kind of shades. You can go really pink with it. You can go very bronze with it. You can go into these more rust tones. So you can kind of like play up whatever kind of colors you're feeling for that day. And I love that it does have a big mirror too. So, and it's a good array of mattes and shimmers, and then you have some like pressed pigment kind of colors in there. So beautiful packaging. It's already getting a little bit dirty though. That's the only like downside of it, is that the flocked material just like is just a magnet for like dust, dirt, and debris. But other than that, it's really gorgeous. And Glamlight was a brand that I wasn't really familiar with, so now that I know that I like their formula, I do want to try out some other palettes from the brand. And then last up is this guy right here. This is the Lorac Pro, the Chocolate Box palette that I opened up in my Tribe Beauty unboxing a couple days ago. I love this as well. This is another one that I have dipped into quite a bit, whether it's the highlighters or the pressed like pigment glitters. It's just a really all-around amazing palette. Like, I can't say enough good about it. I just think that every color is very richly pigmented. It builds up nicely. They're easy to work with. It blends out. It doesn't like get away from you too quickly. Some of these deeper kind of reddy pink colors are very pigmented, so you just need to lightly tap your brush into it. I wouldn't like go in and swirl your brush in it like that. But yeah, these are just beautiful, and I think that they're so unique. The colors are so different and unique that just make them really, really special. So there's some of the like shimmers right there. I was really, you know, I was taken back by the quality of the palette. I thought that it was really, really, really good. And then an honorable mention I thought that I would just throw in is this Yinsa Super 8 Lip Oil that we got in our Allure box. And this is in the Pink Shine shade. I just love the way that this looks when it's held up to the light. It's just like neon. This is a really nice, lightweight, hydrating lip oil. You can definitely wear this on its own. It does have a little tinge of color to it. Not much, but just a little bit of color to it. It's also excellent as a lip topper or to wear at night just to kind of really moisturize and hydrate dry lips, because it does have those 8 super oils in it that helps to hydrate the lips. So that is another thing that I've really been enjoying lately too, to kind of like wear to bed or just to kind of throw in my bag to have something other than a chapstick to kind of throw on. Alrighty, so that is everything from this past month's box, the best of the boxes, if you will. Again, please make sure to thumbs up this video and subscribe while you're at it. And until next time, bye.